drugs surrenderees. So may influx po yung surrenderees sa mga barangays. And then 92% are users and 8% are pushers. And then yung pag-receive dito sa mga sa anti-illegal drug campaign, different. It was received differently by people. There have been positive views about it, and there also have negative views about it. So in this, in the light of this campaign, hindi lang po yung drug users yung naapektuhan. Pati na rin yung mga anak nila. So hindi lang yung asawa, pati na rin yung mga younger children. So according to American Academy of Experts, so those who those who suffer the most or are affected the most are the younger children. So my study seeks to understand how the poor youth have experienced and also cope with living with a recovering family member, yung nag-surrender amidst the government's anti-illegal drug campaign, and underwent the community rehabilitation program, which is the KDPK. So I'll just skip through this. We all know the negative consequences of parental drug misuse. There are a lot of journals about it, a lot of studies on it, how family members are affected. Some are maltreated, some are neglected. So may effects po ito sa kanila. So in their development, and sometimes it leads to them using also drugs. And then there is this construction of a drug use as a in risk environments. Risk environments meaning yung poor communities, those in poverty. So those are risk environments. So some scholars problematize drug use as normative or normal or infused na in everyday lives of people since they have grown up in it, lived in it for so long. Minsan na internalize na nila na wala na akong magagawa. I'm powerless. Hindi na ako makahanap ng trabaho, hindi na ako aral kasi alam nila or they're using drugs or alam ng mga tao na I'm using drugs. Yeah. So in the Philippine setting, hindi ito bago yung drug use, matagal na siya. So 1999, may statistics on it from PDEA and NDLEPC, and then last 2017, PDEA said that almost 50% of barangays are drug affected. And then SWS, nag-survey po sila. And they showed na Filipinos see that it's really common. The presence of drug use is common in the Philippines. So my study wanted to fill this gap. So so I view the vicious cycle of drug use in poor communities as exacerbating the negative psychological and biological effects of taking drugs in the family. So may effect sila sa family members, not only the drug users. Yeah. So we'll skip through that. I used a narrative approach, specifically a layered narrative approach. I did not only listen and analyze their stories, their narratives, but I also looked at the discourses, kung ano yung pinag-uusapan sa community, kung ano yung pinag-uusapan sa pamilya, as well as how they position, how the younger family members position themselves in the community, in the family. So my results, basically, the participants shared their stories of parental drug use and surrendering, as well as the recovery of their parents. So, may dalawang narratives lumabas. There are two stories. Yung isa, yung parental drug use, yung sinasabi nila, nakakahiya yung paggamit ng droga. Nakakahiya yung paggamit ng droga ng parents nila. So, the discourse of shame was really strong. Not only in the family, but also in the community. And then, like that line from Danilo, it's very strong, the discourse of shame. And then the second one is the narrative of surrendering and recovery. So, pagsuko at paghilong ng pamilya, no? In the way Roda said it, sa takot po talaga, baka maaga kami wala ng magulang. So, that's her view. The fear, the discourse of fear was really imminent in the way she told her story. So we'll focus more on the narrative of parental drug use, yung nakakahiya. So again, yung discourse of shame is really common in the communities. So the communities, yung mga tao dun sa komunidad nila, yung mga neighbors, pinagsasabihan na yung pamilya nila na nakakahiya naman, hindi pa kayo nakahihiya, narinig na ng iba, na ganito, ganyan. So those are the stories, the discourses around the community na narinig ng bata. So, by hearing that, sila mismo, sobrang sakit na narinig yan nila, nahihiya na rin sila. So, and then there are three personal narratives in the narrative of parental drug use. So, superordinate yung parental drug use na narrative. But within that, may tatlong personal narratives sila. So, yung isa, sanay na ako, sorry, which is, yung drug use is common, typical in their household. Parang, okay na, sanay na ako, okay lang, nandun siya sa labas, ganun. Because they grew up, even before they were born, from, di ba, their parents are using. And then, the second one is napabayaan ako on neglect. So, the same with literature. Most drug using parents use a parenting style that is not positive. So, nananeglect yung mga anak nyo, napapabayaan. And last, yun, in an extreme case or extreme cases, inaabuso sila, maltreatment. And this abuse creates a resentment or creates nagagalit sila sa parents nila. And then because nagagalit sila at nasasaktan sila, they struggle to say something, to tell them, and to act on it. But most likely in their stories, hindi narinig. They would fight for their agency, they will tell their parents, but hindi narinig. So this is one line from Roda. Parang lumayo na ang loob ko sa kanila, binibigay ko pa rin yung suporta, pero di na. So we'll move to the narrative of surrender and recovery. There's only here the fear discourse is strong. Kasi nung nag-surrender, yun po yung height ng campaign. So fear was really strong in their narratives. And then even the community tells them, instead of shaming them, sinasabihan sila, ay, nagda-drugs yung parents mo. Papasok mo na yan, or paparanggay mo na yan, kasi baka ano mangyari. Parang may concern na. So in this narrative, my personal narratives, yung minimake sense na, they're making sense of it, and trying to say na para sa amin naman yung pagsuko, para sa amin naman to. And then, the next one is nagbago na siya, kaya nagbago na kami. So, basically, surrendering pushed them to change. But to make them change completely is the rehabilitation program. Kasi tuloy-tuloy yun. Pag surrender, diretso sila sa KBDK. This is in Barangay Novaliches proper. Sorry. So, change is seen as the opposite of how it was before. Hindi siya sobrang happy change, but as nawala na yung lahat na nangyari noon yung drug use. So, surrendering and recovery made them realize or made them aware of it na nawala na yun and we're okay na now. So, for discussion, so the findings reveal the emotional turmoil of young family members and their drive to articulate their sentiments. So, meron drive to say something, but minsan, hindi narinig. And fear and shame were used as a discursive tool for change. Okay. So, in implications, there are no existing provisions for young family members who go through the context of parental drug use and surrendering during the current campaign. So, wala masyadong
interventions para sa kanila. Meron sa drug user, marami, different. Sa family, kasi dinudugtong na doon. Pero sa mga younger family members, medyo parang wala pa. O mahirap din silang hanapan ng solution. So implications, I hope that this study contributes to the understanding of the commonness or normality of drug use in communities and its effects on the younger family members. And I hope it develop, it have, has an important implication on the development of interventions such as youth-focused interventions, parent-targeted interventions, and as well as one-specific interventions. Yeah. So findings stress the need for community interventions that help the poor young Filipino family members make sense and cope given their vulnerabilities.